everybody, John Abigail here. Good afternoon greetings from Wichita Falls, Texas.
It is.
Dear, hello and good afternoon. Greetings from Decatur, Weiss, Texas. We are traveling on Interstate 287 North. The temperature here is 80 degrees Fahrenheit. And we are 292 miles to Amarillo, Texas. Not that I'm stopping at Amarillo. It's just a reference on my behalf, on my part. I've got the GPS set at the Big Texan Steakhouse. Sorry to disappoint you, but I am not going there. I've got a lot of food in the truck. If I don't consume that, it's just going to spoil. Not to mention, it's very expensive over there, so... Once again, a happy 65th birthday to Eric Bernholm. August 18th. Happy birthday, Eric. Everybody, Johnny B. Goodyear. Good afternoon. Greetings from Wichita Falls, Texas. All right, we are continuing our journey to Amarillo, Texas, and Aurora, Texas. I'm just using Amarillo as a reference point. The local temperature here it is thought we're gonna go Vernon and Amarillo. Aurora, Colorado, it is 632 miles away. We are currently traveling on Highway 287, I believe. I have this question, and for the sake of my sanity, whatever's left of it, please allow me to ask this question. Please. Of all the people that are dying in Afghanistan right now, why in the world is Joe Biden talking about COVID-19 cases? I don't know, it's just so pathetic. It's just, I don't understand the logic. There are thousands and thousands, maybe 15,000 Americans and other people that are helping the American military that are in desperate need of help. They're going to die if they're not rescued. And our president, Joe Biden, is talking about COVID-19 updates. Oh. I'm done. Sorry. Thank you. Okay, everybody, how about a quick update? Good afternoon, greetings from Vernon Wilbarger, Texas. Wilbarger. Let's just call it Vernon, Texas. Alright, continuing our journey to Aurora, Colorado, which is 581 miles. The temperature here is 81 degrees. Still currently traveling on Interstate Highway 287. And we are 164 miles southeast of Interstate 40. That would probably bring us to Amarillo. Hey everybody, good afternoon, greetings from Chillicothe, Hardyman, Texas. Boy, I'm glad I slowed down. Smoking bear over there, city kitty waiting. Very, very eager to give out tickets. Alright, continuing our journey to Aurora, Colorado, which is 566 miles away, 149 miles to Interstate 40 in Amarillo. Amarillo by morning. Something, something in San Antonio. Don't blink. We're going to be out of this town in about 10 seconds. Yeah, temperature is 90 degrees. Warp 9.5. Engage. ladies and gentlemen, once again, welcome to Juana Hardiman. This is Juana, Texas. 89 degrees. We are down to 553 miles to Aurora, Texas. Colorado. Yeah. And I'm telling you, it's not easy having a Teflon for a brain. Hardly anything sticks to it, you know what I mean?
Eventually died.
a serious note, I wonder how much Lazarus remembered. You know, Lazarus was not the only one that came back to life. I wonder if those people in biblical times, and I'm not talking about these guys that are, they were dead in 3 minutes or 5 minutes. I'm talking about people back then that died in days. I wonder how much of the, they remember, you know? Ah, look at that meter belt. Oh, you stink. Ew, you stink, man. You stinky meter belt, you. Ew. Warp speed. Factor 5. Engage. are trending in this day and age is old style pickup with rustic look to it. They actually will buy old pickup trucks or cars with the original rundown looking paint job instead of cars looking brand new. They leave it looking a little bit shaggy, and that supposedly adds value to it. I was watching this episode on YouTube about this HOA. HOA has rules that you can't park a vehicle in your driveway with rust spots in it. And you can't just park there and not drive it. So this guy bought a pickup truck, fixed it all up, runs like a brand new car, spent a lot of money to make it run good, good running condition, but he left the paint the way it was, and the HOA fined him $100 a day, and man, I tell you, those HOAs are like Gestapos. I would never live in a HOA place. Total Dynamic Hoist. Looks like a brand spanking new vehicle. Childress, like a dress, Childress. Oh, we got an inspection station coming up. Oh boy. I hope the wait is going to be okay. Everybody, greetings from Esteline, Texas. Not much else here. I think that was it. Next town up is Memphis, 14 miles. Ooh, that's